So here, as you can see, that I've made three sets, and each set is capable of 82.3 ampere hours each. Now the next step is apply wooden bolt and your battery sets. So this is the positive side and this is your negative side. So it's going to be placed like this. Now take the other one and place them like this, and here I'm going to use this cardboard as the separator. Now comes the third one. So this is going to go in reverse like this one, negative up, and again separator. So after completing this much, we will move on towards connecting the three battery sets in series. And since it is not like a single cell, but 32 cells connected together to make one big set. So this time we are going to need thicker nickel strips to carry that huge current. So this is the one that I'm going to use this time. It's much thicker than before. So guys, now that the series connection of the batteries is fully complete, let's test it, and you can see that it is working. So this one is a 55 watts bulb. Here, as you can see, 12 volts, 55 watts. So let's check the battery voltage, and here we have 11.73 volts. A little bit discharged. It's fully charged at 12.5. So now comes the use of my 12 volts, 40 amps BMS, 12.6. Now guys, here as you can see is the BMS, and the strips, I have welded them, all of them, to the positive terminal of the BMS. You can see this is positive, and this part is also positive, so that it can transfer huge current with the three strips. So here as you can see is my 4mm wire that will be placed like this, but first I should place some flux. So here, as you can see, that I've strongly soldered this wire on the positive terminals, these two, to utilize full possible current, and also on the strips. So this is going to be great. Now comes the zero point. This will be connected to the negative. Now comes the part of connecting strips to the ground terminal, which is zero. Okay. Now I'm going to add another strip on this side to increase up the carrying amps. The welding part on the 0V terminal of the BMS is complete. Now I'm going to make it even more stronger by soldering it. Other side of the 0V terminal. So after the 0V terminal comes the negative terminal, the overall negative of the BMS. Now the negative one is also complete. So for 4.2, I will be using this green wire. And for 8.4, I'm gonna use this red one. So guys, that's the 0V overall negative terminal, and I've welded it to the overall battery negative. You can see. Now comes the green terminal. You see this one? This has to be connected to the 4.2 volts. So the 4.2 volts wire has also been connected. Now comes the final 8.4 volts wire, the red one. So the BMS connection to the battery pack is finally complete. Let's connect this 55 watts bulb and test it. Let's hope it works. Okay. Yo, so we are doing really good here. Here, as you can see guys, that I've finally completed my battery pack. So now it's time to conduct its full testing. Starting with the voltage test. Here we have 11.71 volts DC. Now let's do the weight measurement, and here as you can see we have 4.2 kgs. So guys, here we have the clamp meter, and I've placed it to this wire, the blue one, positive one. So let's move the pointer to DC current measurement mode, and that's a high current DC motor. I will show you its winding thickness. here, as you can see, it's quite thick. So let's try this one. Okay, let's see the peak amperes. Whoa, you saw the peak amps were around 15, 16. Moving on to the next high current motor, this is a bike starter motor. Now I'm not sure if this can run it or it's gonna get damaged, but I gotta try this. Okay, keep watching the multimeter display. Whoa, 22 amperes. I think the BMS is protecting itself by turning off. So let's make sure that everything is fine with the battery pack and the BMS. I'm going to connect this 55 watts bulb and also see the amps this one draws. So it's 5. So now I'm going to test my next high current motor. It's 24 volts, 500 watts. So let's try this one. It's quite heavy. I'm going to hold it steady. So 15 amperes. 18. So 18 was the maximum current that we saw displayed on the screen of the multimeter. So that's that. Now let's see how much voltage we are left with now. So at the beginning of the test, we were around 11.71 volts and great, it is still the same, 11.71. Obviously the battery is huge. Now guys, this BMS can handle a maximum of 13.6 volts DC. So I'm going to use this variable power supply. Yeah, that is 13.6. Now this one. Now when I'm going to connect this wire, the voltage here displayed should drop. See, 12.5. Oh, the current drawn is huge. So here if you can see, it is drawing 5.5 amperes, even though this piece is rated for a max of, how much is it? 3 amperes. So at present I have to feed huge current. This is like, needs a lot of juice. So this charger is going to feed it. Yeah. So guys, now my battery pack is fully charged. Let me show you the voltage. Here as you can see, it's showing 12.4 volts, which is pretty good. It was initially 11.71 and now it is 12.42. Now guys, for my power station project, I will also be using one more battery pack, this one, which as you can see, I'm connecting in parallel to the previous set. So the two batteries have been connected in parallel and the overall voltage, as you can see, for both the sets is 12.15 volts. So let's test this bike starter motor this time. Okay. Whoa. As you can see, it works now. The current is huge. Close up.